Welcome to the Fry Stuff webinar series for entrepreneurship. We promise to deliver every Friday something informative and useful to the innovation, entrepreneurship, and startup community of Anna University, the affiliated colleges, and the members of public. So today we have Dr. Uma Maheshwari to talk on how the incubation centers or the incubators can support the startups in their entrepreneurship pursuits. So a very warm welcome, Dr. Uma Maheshwari. And I'm very pleased to have you here as part of the Fry Stuff series. So to give a brief on Dr. Uma Ma'am's background, Dr. Uma Maheshwari is currently serving as the CEO, Chief Executive Officer of Anna Atal Incubation Center. She is also the founder of TechWorks, a rapid prototyping consulting firm, which provides training for schools and colleges about new technologies such as 3D printing, IoT, and AI. Prior to this, Dr. Maheshwari has been managing the technology business incubator at Sastra University. Uma Ma'am had a long career of about 7 years with the CII, the Confederation of Indian Industry, as the executive officer in supply chain management. She had also been associated with the ICFAI, where she got an opportunity to work with the MBA students. To put things together, Dr. Maheshwari is a multifaceted, strong woman leader with wide experience in marketing, HR, operations, supply chain management, skill development, in addition to steering and managing innovation and entrepreneurship ecosystem. Academically, Dr. Uma Maheshwari holds a degree in computer science, an MBA in marketing and HR management, and a doctorate, a PhD degree in logistics and supply chain management, in addition to certifications in supply chain and purchase and materials management. So it's time now to hand the stage over to Dr. Uma Maheshwari and learn about the role of centers in supporting the startups. Welcome, Uma Ma'am.
Thank you, Sangeeta. For your that overwhelming intro. And I'm so humbled by the welcome address, and thank you so much. So let me take a minute to share my screen.
Yeah. Yeah, we can see. Yes.
Hope my screen is visible, and a very good afternoon to all. Great to see you all people here on a wonderful Friday. And Fry Stuff is as name itself is like very mind-blowing name that the team has got. So glad about being a part of this initiative, the talk series. So today I'm going to handle a session on role of incubators in supporting the startups. So role of incubators, where comes the role of incubators in a startup ecosystem? What if a startup is on its journey, where or what in what way incubator can support the startup in growing or the reach, so growth, where is it involved? So that's the kind of introduction, or that's the kind of the coverage the session is going to give you. So having set the expectation, I'll move on to the session. So I want to put across the first question here. Are you a first-time entrepreneur? Are you a first-time entrepreneur, especially with the technology-driven startup idea? Because any idea can be a startup. See, even if it is a tea shop, it's a startup on its own. So it doesn't have any demarcation as far as the startup is concerned. But when it is on the technological space, when it is really on the technical side, that's the major focus here, because incubators, if we see, there are a lot of technology-based incubators. So let me put across this question very clear, because are you a first-time entrepreneur with a technology-driven startup idea? Yes. If you say yes to this question, of course, you are on the right track. We'll move on to the next section, because technology is one word that is actually that makes the business or the startup idea entirely different from the other segments. So that is where the incubator's role come into picture. If you are in a normal, any business that is very generic in nature, that does not involve any technology, that does not have any pertinence of technology into it, then the scenario is completely different. You don't have to reach out to even business incubators. Rather, you have a common ideology of what that business is all about. You can go to such businesses, view them, watch them, learn, and then come back. But technology-driven startup idea, you have a lot of processes in it. So once if you touch an idea that is 100% technology-driven, or even 50% technology-driven, then there are a lot of legal procedures. There are a lot of formalities that you may have to go through, which are very, very essential. And so that is where the role of incubator becomes so very predominant. And 90% of the business ideas, 90% of the techno-based business ideas, techno-based business entrepreneurs who are now on ground are first-time entrepreneurs. So this is once, this may sound little, weird, but then this is the truth. Because technology, as it evolves, when it evolves, entrepreneurs also grow with it. So that's the beauty of technology. So 90% of the techno-based startup ideas, 90% of the technology-based startups all will have the first-time entrepreneurs in place. So they would have gone through all sort of hurdles that any person who is in the startup phase is going through now also. So that's the very, very important takeaway that one should have. If at all you are into a technology-based startup idea, of course, you have to take this into mind, digest the fact that you are also going to be on the same journey and move ahead with the same kind of steps and processes involved in building that startup. Reasons why startup fails. So let us analyze it in a perspective very clearly. Why the startups generally fail? Because in India, if we see like, out of 100 startups that are started in a year, and if you take 1% of them out of not just 100 startups, if you say all the startups that have been started in India, it's only 1% that gets success. So this 1% success is a very, very disturbing factor, because people are having that interest in starting a business. They all put up their heart and mind and soul into the business idea, everything. But then eventually it fails, and the reason has to be analyzed. So that's why. So that's the reason we are sitting here to analyze this part. Reasons why the startups fail. First segment, stuff is that they may come up with a product which the market does not need. So any particular business idea should have a strong underlying problem. Only then it becomes a proper, then the solution will be properly understood by the customer segment. So the problem necessity, if it is not there, then naturally the product would not be of need to the market. Then if there is no need in the market for the product, then there is no way that the startup can be successful. So no market need is one basic or the biggest reason for the failures of the startup. Second, they run out of cash, of course, because funding, finance, capital, all are very important. So when a system doesn't allow someone to have that money flow into structure, then eventually they fail. They don't have a right team. Most of the startups that are failing today, they don't have a right team in place. And they get outcompeted, which means like they are overridden by another technology or overridden by somebody else, because somebody will come and overtake. Because that's the continuous evolution or the change that this startup has to go through would be missing. So that is one among the predominant reasons because of which the startups fail. Cost issues may happen even due to inflation, because the inflation is there in every single segment. Now you can very well see the price hike in the LPG, the fuel charges, which will directly and indirectly have effects on the logistics, effect on the production. So all these are the reasons, prominent reasons that usually affect the business. So there may be reasons like the other side. See, one section is completely on the, some of them are controllable, some of them are uncontrollable. Some of them has to be on a plan-based system, because if it is not planned well, then that may lead to failure. So if you are a product that doesn't have a friendly or easy access, if the product is not completely, it is not so very user-friendly, then naturally your product may fail, because that is one of the reasons that today's, the customer segment are facing. If your product is not user-friendly, they don't feel like using it for a long run. So that's why the concept of design thinking or all into system. Once if you are into design thinking, then you will know the right way of designing the product, which will be accepted by the customers. So a very user-friendly product has to be evolved out. So that is one reason. And product without a proper business model, if you don't have a business model, because generally first-time entrepreneurs, they don't have proper guides. They will not know how to draft a plan for them. How to create a sustainable business model is a big question. I can run a business for today. I can run a business for 6 months and 1 year. But definitely, I will be out of market once if I don't have that sustainable business plan in place. So sustainable business model is something which I got to work on. And so that's another reason. So business models cannot be evolved by individuals themselves. They need a proper guide. They need that ecosystem to sit and discuss with proper mentors, proper teams. So it's very essential that the business model should also be supportive for your growth. Poor marketing is another reason, because you don't know where to start in the market. Generally, if you know all of the techno-based entrepreneurs, they're not MBAs, so-called MBAs. So even if they are MBA, also people make mistakes, because that's the actual scenario, because you are readily on ground to do it. That is different from than writing in paper. So somebody can be over performer in examinations, but definitely on ground, if somebody is asking to do proper marketing, then definitely it's going to be a tough game. So poor marketing techniques, poor marketing strategy will lead you to failure. Ignoring some customers, that may be due to your technical incompetency or your competitors, or it may be the way that you can handle some customers, because all customers are not same. So you are handle every customer in a different way. So that way, even ignoring customers would be one of the reasons for your, you know, failure. Product mistimed, match of time. So that's another reason. If you're not tapping the market on a right time, yeah, then you lost the game. So you got to tap the market on a right time, ahead of the journey. So all these factors put together make startup very, when you combine all the positive part of these, if you take all everything on a positive note and put it across in a shell and give it for a startup, then that would be a successful one. And these are the predominant reasons why these startups fail. So having analyzed all the reasons for failure and all the reasons for success, we can now put it in three categories, right? A startup should have right people with right plan and at right place. So getting the team members or the core team members and the staffs, and getting a proper business strategy, business plan, a value proposition model, all the paper related plan documents in place, and also a right place for them to reach out to market, right place to do R&D, right place to experiment and test out their product. All these has to be there. So that's why I've divided these three aspects as major role players. So people, plan, and the place. So let us have a close look at the start of Tamil Nadu, because it's very important that we are addressing the needs of Tamil Nadu entrepreneurship here. So actually, the state has a beautiful history. It has 8.4%, it's an 8.4% contributor, which to the GDP, which is the second largest contribution in the country. And it is very good in industries, and there are a lot of people who have come down and invested in Tamil Nadu for their industrial growth. And this state has created a lot of employment opportunities. And if you see if you compare Tamil Nadu's composition of the industry model along with any other state, I can say very clearly that Tamil Nadu stays much ahead of the other states in the industrial composition. And total workforce share, the industry workforce share is taken almost to 16% by the state. So 16% of the total industrial workforce would be contributed by Tamil Nadu. And it has beautiful FDI inflows. So ranked third in terms of getting FDI inflows into the state. And renewable energy, we have beautiful energy renewable energy capacity. And we have power plants that are supplying enough of requirements. And we have, the state has beautiful education infrastructure so that new talents can be created on every year-on-year basis, new avenues of development could be even taught to the students, and the students will come up with right capacity, the right talent to reach out to these kind of evolving technologies. Almost the urbanized population, like 48.5% of the state's urbanized population belong, like is urbanized. So that's another another advantage that the state has. So putting all these together, there are beautiful scope that one can come out with wonderful ideas and have startups in place that could actually serve a problem. So if the problems are stronger, the solution addresses the problem in the right way, if you have right plan in place, the right people in place, if you have right place to work on, then the state actually facilitates you to grow very well in terms of pulling out the business model in place. And so how to build your product or a business, how to build a product or a business takes all these phases. So problem, let us first understand the problem, because any business has to start with the problem. So let us analyze a problem. If that problem is very strong, and if that problem requires proper attention and solution to be served out, so then that becomes the critical, that decides the necessity of the business. So underlying problems should be very strong. Followed by that, the problem should be faced by a set of customers. Even that we are coming up with a lot of niche marketed products. For example, we see the food for race horses evolving out very beautifully now. In Chennai, it's food for race horses are like very much food products or food packages for the race horses. I'm just giving you a non-tech business example. This is a very critical example on a niche market, because the horse food, yeah, of course, that itself is a very niche market. But if you see race horse food, it is entirely different from normal horse food. So that kind of problem is analyzed. Yeah, there is a problem for the nutritional, the problem called nutritional deficit for the race horses. So that problem is underlying. So to come up or overcome the problem that is underlying here, somebody has come up with a solution of a food package that serves the need of that race horse. Of course, that's a solution. So even when it is a niche product and the solution is very appropriate, then naturally the pricing strategy falls in place. That's it. So you come up with a problem, and you have a set of customers who are addressing or who are facing that problem. And you come up with a product that could solve the problem, which is perceived as a solution by the customer because he has been facing the problem. So your product appeals to them as a solution. And then you think about, market, you go to the market, you start pricing it, because you would see what are the other price ranges, how much they spend on a race horse food. And all these would be the data for you. You understand that pattern and you price the product. You then scale it as reaching out or blowing your business big, scale the business, and then go for funding. That's another way which you can very probably, which is very, very, logical in terms of that. So these are the phases generally would anyone have to face in a business. So having said that, if you're coming up with a robo for helping agriculturists, then the same procedure has to be understood. So we got to start with the problem where the robo is going to be beneficial for the agriculturalist or farmer on field. So who are the customers? What are the proportion of customers in the total, the geographical location or the market that you're going to serve? Maybe national or international. And what is the kind of product and how it is solving the problems of the customer? So farmers, how the problem see your product. A farmer see your product, and then you go to the market, you start pricing it based on the present way, because most of the activities in agriculture are all, labor driven. So having that in place, substituting labor forces with technology is pretty hard, but then it is a necessity, because the present agricultural ecosystem does not have so much of manpower in place. So naturally, the losses due to lack of manpower is very high. To address that, we have technology in place. So this is the structure we generally have to look at. And then you go for scaling, which is escalating or blowing your business, and then go for funding. Funding is usually a way through which you raise funds for your business. You try to pull in investors, you try to do various strategies to attract investments to your business. So these are the processes usually will happen. What is the role of an incubator in this? You can start from phase 1 to phase 8. So wherever you want, you feel like somebody has to be there with you, the incubators can help you out. Because it's not just, if I say like, we'll help you in identifying problem, we'll help you in customers. No, we can be of any role. Usually an incubator can take a role of a mentor. Usually incubator can take a role of a facility provider. Incubator can also be a place where investments can be roped in. So these are the segments in which we can be helpful to you. Having said that, mentors are not just for anything, not just for only drafting the business plan, drafting the investment deck, nothing. So mentors can be facilitators in assessing whether your selected problem area is right or not. Even from that level, the incubators can have role. Problem identification usually will be done by the business startup entrepreneurs. So they identify the problem, they'll just find out what their product is, how the first four phases generally will be done by the entrepreneurs. But if you want any help, you can always reach out to any incubators, you can reach out to any entrepreneurial development cells, which can help you out in getting the four stuff started. Coming to the next segment of four, product development can be done with the help of an incubator. They can give you facility, they can give you lab access, they can give you technical mentors. So all these can be provided by the incubators. And the solution can be built, IP, fetching IP or registering for IP, and then product registration, trademarking, everything can be facilitated with the help of an incubator in place. And market connect can be provided by the incubator, because incubators are known for creating a lot of events, known for networking platforms, providing networking platforms. And they are known for, they can very well help you out in doing the right pricing strategy in place with the help of comparative market analysis. And also using the same networking platform, one can have market connect and they can also scale their business. And there are also opportunities in incubators providing funding partners in place. So we can facilitate you helping VC venture capitalists. So venture capitalists and angel investors in place who could help you scale your business, keep the investment process on. So that will be really, really supported by the incubator. So if you start from the first phase to the last phase, there are every phase in which incubators can be approved. And there are, actually, if you look at an incubator, it has to combinedly work with other ecosystems. So rightly, if you see AIC, Anna University is now, actually ecosystem partner for Anna University, major ecosystem partner is CED, Center for Entrepreneurship Development. So we work in a network, and so this is very concealed and a very sweet network that keeps working outreach programs that helps one another. So that kind of ecosystem should be there for an incubator. How to choose an incubator is another art for a startup. So I would say like a startup who would like to choose an incubator should have some criteria in mind, basic facilities, how the mentors, the type of mentors they provide, the kind of ecosystem in which the incubator is located, the market access from the incubator, the network of people. All these matters a lot for the startup to get closer and start working with an incubator, because incubator is just like a partner. It's not like a person who is helping you out. No service, it's only partnership. So we feel like we are partners to you, equally responsible for your growth. So that's where the incubator's step is pretty much higher. So if you look at the fast-growing businesses after 2020, it's all about smart health, smart education, the smart society, which covers the city infrastructure, the smart city platform, the smart tech city infrastructural things, and smart agriculture, and then fintech. So these are the promising areas in which generally the you see lost lot of fast growing businesses are. So said that, incubators will generally have focus areas in any of these, and they'll have infrastructural setup supporting businesses in any of these areas. Usually technology business incubators or incubators that are supporting technology-based startups will have their focus areas are falling under any of these categories. So you're in all these categories, you can always include anything and everything. You can have unmanned aerial vehicle. It's name a technology, blockchain. Yeah, it is there. Unmanned aerial vehicle. Yeah, it is there. And you also have IoT. You also have rapid prototyping for product. Prototyping, design, everything is included in this five categories. And that's the beauty of, and that's why these five categories are in place. So it's all about choosing a right incubator that falls, that exactly serves or that exactly caters the need of that particular startup. So it's very important that mapping has to be there. So to talk about the AIC based startups, of course, these are the various startups that we have. And we have almost like 66 co-founders, 24 startups in place right now. 16 women co-founders are there in these startups and one all women led startup. So totally, if you see, this is a right composition, I would say. In this 24, we have enough of the composition of all the technologies which I mentioned earlier. So this is about AIC AU. Similarly, if you look at any incubator for that matter, they'll also have all kind of the focus area related startups in place. So the startups generally will have to look at the focus area and the infrastructure available. That's the key driven point for them. So supporting initially with the idea, somebody is coming up with the idea. All they need is a facility to develop their prototype and then further facilities to evolve the prototype into a product. These two would generally be supported by all the incubation ecosystem, entrepreneurship ecosystem. So having said that, these two would naturally end up in building a product. Once after you build your product, then the story of elevating the business is next phase. So everything related to a business till you become completely sustainable. As a startup, you should become completely sustainable all by yourself. Till then, the role of incubators can be continued. So that's the beauty of incubation in India. And Anna University also has an incubation center that is supported by Atal Innovation Mission. And this is in the right ecosystem, wherein you have a lot of experts coming out and do expert sessions every week and every month. So we have proper incubating expert sessions in place. And then grant supplied, and then we're waiting for the grants as well. And always we do one investor pitch, which will help the startups to escalate their business to the next level. So these are the predominant areas in which our startups has been so very successful. Attracted many funds as well. You know, investments and funding opportunities have been explored. To talk about the technology, it's all about the smart. Whatever you call it as a smart, or the digital transformation or a digitalization of the product, all will fall under the pertinence of AICAU. So our vision is to create an ecosystem that fosters creativity, curiosity, innovation, and leads to entrepreneurship, thereby creating a better nation. We would like to build a nation's competence with entrepreneurship and innovation. And our goal is to provide you a world-class incubation facility with all that you need, right from the problem solution fit to the financially, till you make your a business financially viable and investable business. So this is about the incubator's role and about AICAU. So I'm stopping here for a minute. Please put forth your question if at all you have.
Okay, you want questions in between. Okay. Yeah, we are okay with any format. So participants, Uma ma'am has stopped in between, taken a pause, so that if you have any questions, you can, unmute and ask her. Please say your name and ask Uma ma'am. We can't hear you. Who is this Jay? We can't hear you. Can you put in the chat box then? the question. Can you please put the question in the chat box? Your voice is breaking.
Yeah, it's echoing actually. We are unable to hear you. Can you put it in the chat box if you don't mind?
Okay, how about others?
Mr. Suhail has asked one question that, you know, will this help to scale the existing business, like a family business? So, of course, it can, as long as your family business is completely fitting into the focus area of the incubator. Yeah, we are very much into the system. It doesn't mean that somebody has to actually come up with a startup. Even if you have a product idea that you want to evolve out, even out of your family business system, yeah, we can help you out. So, should not be a problem.
Yeah.
And
Jeeva
Ram sir has asked a question, like while choosing an incubator, is an equity charged by them? There are some incubators who charge equity, usually would be on legal terms. It can be discussed, it can be very clearly ratified across, and then because incubators generally will help you out and right from the journey, right from the start of your journey till the end. So there are agreement systems in which equity charges are done. So if equity charges are done, you can get it ratified. You can have any dilutable, non-dilutable, whichever is applicable for you. In that form, you can go ahead and move further. Because without equity charging, I don't think incubators can be sustainable even, because it's a continuous process that somebody has to support the complete ecosystem altogether. So it's needed. And Sharan Kumar.
What's the percentage, Uma, you want to mention? Give
usually
a range.
Percentage would be up to 3%, 3 to 5% usually. You know, I'm not up to 3%, 3 to 5%. It can be lesser than that also, based on the your negotiation power. You can even start discussing and negotiate it. So
okay.
Explain once again about incubator. Incubators are nothing but bodies or cells or system that can help you out in starting your business, right from start of your business till your end, till you become successful in the business, be on your own to create your own revenues and investments. So we'll help you out. The incubators will generally be helping you out in every single phase of your business so that it becomes self-sustainable all by itself. The purpose of having incubator in place is to help or support the first-time entrepreneurs, even if not first-time entrepreneurs, the tech-based entrepreneurs who need right infrastructure and support to make their business successful. So this is the purpose of an incubator. So an incubator can take any role. If you feel like you want a person to share your burden and, you know, come down, say, take the advice from, the right option would be to have an incubator in place. So that's the role of an incubator.
Right.
And how do we convey the...
Please, Deepthi's question.
Sorry. Deepthi has asked a question. How do we convey the importance of pre-incubation period to the students? Pre-incubation period is more to understand your business all by yourself. Because pre-incubation, we have nothing to do with, we generally don't want to do pre-incubation if somebody has an established business in place. But even for them, we feel like they have to run through their business process once again and find out where they actually have to rework on. Because revisiting, unlearning is another aspect of growing the business. So it's better that one can, if you want to convince if you want to talk to the students about the importance of pre-incubation, you can always tell them evaluating, self-evaluation of idea happens in pre-incubation. It's very important that somebody has to sit and evaluate your idea all by yourself. You know, you have to do it for yourself. But there are various criteria of self-evaluation even. Sometimes we go myopic, and we may not be addressing every single aspect of self-evaluation, but a pre-incubation period allows you that, space and bandwidth to do assessment, self-assessment in every single aspect of assessing a startup. So in finance, in business plan, in everything that you see for essentials of a business, you have to do a self-evaluation of business. Generally, if you are allowed to do self-evaluation, you will create a criteria. But pre-incubation is incubator-created criteria for self-evaluation of a startup. So you can convey the importance to the students this way. So this is for Deepthi and Suhail.
What are the facilities? Okay, no. Do incubators accept simple ideas like mobile or web application?
Yes, as long as your mobile and web application matters or caters to the specific problem of the customers, of course we take it. Because if you see a lot of our incubatees whom we have right now, all many of them, like 30% or more of them are SaaS. So no software application developers. So they have web application, they have mobile based application development. So all these are, if they are acceptable, I mean, all these are acceptable for incubator as long as it serves a strong problem, it finds the right solution to the customer.
Right, so, right. Next is a general question, Uma. So what are the facilities that Anna Incubator has for the students of main campus of Anna University? So can you list out a few facilities that startups can benefit from?
Yes. First and foremost, we have lab facilities, fabrication lab for prototyping. We also have tied up with, we have also a great understanding with CED, which also has a maker lab. So prototypes can be developed both with the help of maker lab and the fab lab with us. And we have basic IoT infrastructure in place, which can be open for the students or any person who comes up with a startup idea. So we the difference is like we don't limit ourselves only for students, but students are also welcome here. So we don't stop students from getting into here. And there are training activities which are being planned for the students, which will also be another kind of knowledge session to the students who can learn and try out their ideas with they're very particular about growing startups. Of course, they can try out their idea with the help of the infrastructure available. So IoT lab facilities are available. Basic healthcare related analysis and information recorders are available. So basic health startup setup can be fetched in, and that is also accessible. The students who becomes incubators or who are running their startups will also get access to a ecosystem which has more than 10 mentors and wonderful business advisors. They can get access to a lot of startup packages like AWS, Wakil Search. So we have beautiful tie-up with all these people to have your startup journey comfortable. So this can also be provided. And apart from that, students, those who want to have just to be a part of these startups, not as they don't want to run a startup, but we would like to be a part of the startup. If students are something, students are, there are some students who have that kind of a mindset. Of course, you're welcome for the internship. We offer a lot of internships from our startup companies, which can be taken right royally with the Anna University students, by the non students, and they can show their competence, learn, and then give back to the ecosystem. That is also possible. So we open avenues of various kinds to make them explore the entrepreneurship segment. They can be a part of this ecosystem as an entrepreneur, as well as a student into a startup journey. So this is also possible, because if you see, for example, we have a company called Rapti Energy. Rapti Energy Private Limited. So these people, Rapti Energy, have taken more than 10 interns right from Anna University campus. So they have taken interns from all the their needed areas they have listed, and they have taken interns who are still working on there in supply chain, in HR, in engineering, in all product design, embedded systems. Everywhere there are interns who sits and work for the organization. If they like, you've got to prove your competence, and if you want to earn a pre-placement, of course they are open to give you a pre-placement as well. This is one of the beautiful structure where you give and take your benefits. So right. These are the facilities that we provide, or opportunities that we provide for the students of an university.
Right. Nice. So Sanjay wants to know what kind of non-technical startups have been founded at Anna Incubator.
Non-technical, to be very frank, Anna University, Anna Incubation Cell will not facilitate non-technical startups, because technology startups are all supported. Only technology startups will be supported. Non-tech, we don't have option for that, because being in Attell's incubation center, it has to be completely on any of the focus areas, technology focus areas like smart health, smart education, smart society, fintech. So these are the kind of any smart or any technology enabled deep tech or not non-deep tech, but then technology enabled startups would be appropriate to be incubated at AIC.
Right. I think we have faculty members as well. So Dr. Marceline Rajani wants to know, how can a college register as an incubation center, register an incubation center, any financial support from Anna University?
Incubation center, if you want to apply, you've got to go for like you know, central support. It is not like university driven. You can be a part of you know, if you want to, if you are just starting, then you have to register your company, like Section 8 company, and then the foundation has to be established for, and then go for funding, which is done through various bodies like NITI, I mean DST, NITI Aayog. You can go via them. So in Anna University, we have specific incubation centers which are supported. For example, CED is an entrepreneurial wing, and AIC is an entrepreneurial wing. So we have such places through which you can make use of. Actually, you don't have to actually go and establish a center, but you can send your students here, or you can send your ideas via CED through to us, and we will combinedly help you out in getting the startup successful.
Right, and the same person wants to know, if any of our student wants to utilize the incubation center at Anna University, is it possible? What is the procedure or fees needed to pay, ma'am?
Actually, it's
time, Uma. Please give us the procedure if somebody wants to get incubated.
Yes,
please.
I just want to do it off the presentation, and that's why I stopped my presentation and that. So having said that, coming to that point of you know, how a student or any you know, startup can come inside an incubation center. You can send an application, or you know, you can directly drop in here to meet us. So either ways are fine. Once you're coming down here to meet us, or you can even take the mail ID, which I'm I'll put it in the chat box. So you can drop.
You have the contact slide? Any slide with the contacts?
Yes, I do have. I'll share that slide.
Okay, we'll share it in a minute then.
Yeah, so that you can take out, and then you can drop a mail to us. The first step is to drop a mail to us with your business idea or the idea for reaching out to us, why you have to reach out to an incubator. Just drop it in a few lines and we will get back to you. And after that, the procedure would be, we'll have to have a web meeting or a physical meeting to go through your idea in an elaborated way. And once after your idea is, you know, fitting into the structure, fitting into the focus area of the incubation cell, yeah, of course, we can incubate you with a simple agreement signature. You can be a part of incubation. But the scrutinization would be done by a panel. So that panel will not have me or anybody else. There is an external panel which evaluates your idea and sees whether it is its ability to fit into the incubation system will be evaluated. And then you will be given a communication on your selection. So if you are selected, so following that agreement will be signed across, and you can start your pre-incubation period. So first phase would be after selection, first phase would be pre-incubation. That's what self-evaluation of the idea. The pre-incubation is not just to, screen. It is just about to tell you if you are going somewhere wrong. The panel of mentors will sit and dedicate time with you to correct those mistakes and keep you on track of doing the business. So a pre-incubation would be for 10 weeks, so 2.5 months. Following that, there will be another evaluation panel. So you may have to present it in front of the panel, because the more and more you present, the more and more you evolve out with your business plan, the better would be in terms of reaching out to investors, because it is always you're going to talk. So it's better that you can keep talking and then keep evolving your models whenever is required, and go ahead. So once after the pre-incubation 10 weeks is over, you will be analyzed once again, evaluated once again by an evaluation panel. And following that, you will be given a incubation. Incubation, you can take use of the co-working space. We'll give you space here to sit and work. And there will be lab facilities open for you, which you can take out. There are a lot of benefits related to company registration, mentor access, technical support. All these will be provided on a very, on a regular intervals, for which we don't charge, but extra stuff which you want to do. For example, if you want to go for prototyping prints or prototyping models, then you may have to spend some money. Those are completely dependent on the variable note. How much ever you do, then how much ever you want to use, you may have to pay. So there is no stipulated fees here, but we charge you based on the usage.
Right.
That's it.
Yeah. Can I add a couple more points here, Uma?
Yeah, please.
I thought this is the right platform to talk about. So all the participants, for your information, Dr. Uma Maheshwari is from Anna Atal Incubation Center. which is open to anybody. Students and faculty members of Anna University, our affiliated colleges, or the members of public. So anybody who has an idea or a prototype or wants to set up a business, a startup, can walk into Atal Incubation. In addition to Atal Incubation Center, we also have something called CEGAIN, which is CEG Alumni Incubation Center, which is specifically for the alumni of CEG, the College of Engineering of Anna University. Anna University has four campuses, CEG, AC Tech, MIT, and SAP. So CEG is the major college in Anna University. And so this incubation is only for the alumni of CEG students, those who are alumni of CEG college. In addition to this, there is a third incubator called UIC, University Innovation Cluster, which is BIREC sponsored. And it has been renamed as EYUVA Kendra now. But that is not that doesn't function like a standard incubator the way Uma ma'am has been explaining. It calls for fellowship programs, and students working in biotech and pharma industry can write proposals and get selected for the fellowship program and get incubated in UIC or the EUA Kendra. So three incubation facilities are there in Anna University, and for the benefit of the students and the faculty members. So I just wanted to add that. And Uma ma'am, can you talk about in your prior experience as well, how have the faculty members been? Like, have they been very active in, setting up startups and all that? How has your experience been about the faculty?
Actually, in the earlier incubator where I had been, there were some startups initiated, run and managed by the faculty members along with the students. Yeah, right. It's all they take the help of students in terms of managing the startup, but right. They'll be the brain behind the startup. So right. it becomes very successful because there is someone who has put in enormous technical effort on one end, and there'll right. be fresh minds on the executionary ends who can be guided and who can be taken ahead. So that's one model which I had seen in my earlier incubator experience. But I've also come across the IIT Madras incubation cells proportion, where there are a lot of faculty-driven startups. Driven in the sense is sometimes those are established by faculty members and driven by a set of alumni students or fresh students as well. So that is again one interesting way. So I would say faculty-led startups or faculty-driven startups are getting very popular nowadays. And the research papers, what they write, the researchers that they do are enormous. So it's very easy for them to pick up most successful and most appealing research front, and they are the right brains to convert that into a product as well. So right. this product conversion also happens with the help of their research strength. So correct. Rightly, rightly speaking, they should actually own the startup and run it. So it is open. Even the faculty, the AIIC fraternity, AIIM fraternity is more towards Atal Innovation Mission. If you see an Atal Incubations Centers, all are open for faculty-led startups. So startups at the faculty, we are open to have. Very nice. Much. Yeah, there is again a huge advantage that faculty startups will have in terms of AIIM is concerned as well. A student-led startup is equally as important as a faculty-led startup. So,
excellent. Yeah. Excellent. Thank you, Uma, for that.
Especially women, Sangeeta. So that's another another important area which I would like to touch upon. We recently have come across AIIM has given a special segment for women entrepreneurship, and they're going to be picking up some wonderful women-led entrepreneurial ventures name.
Yeah.
Have a big blow for them. So awards are being provided, grants are being given. A lot of VCs and AIs interested in investing on women startups. So March 8th, the hangama is very big.
So, Women's Day. To add to your point, on the GEM portal, which is the government's portal, the purchase of products that are needed in government offices. So 25% of the purchases are to be done from MSMEs. And out of which, 3%, 3-4% are to be taken from the women-led startups. So that is something reserved for women entrepreneurs. So it's such a nice reservation. I think all women should be aware of it and should make use of it. So they have a reservation, and so all the government tenders and purchases should be done through from a government-led, a women-led MSME. So that's something which is nice to know, motivating enough. So I think we can continue with your slideshow. You have a couple more slides.
No, I'm done with that because I just want to stop it and continue only on a physical note because, you know, it's all about the procedures which I wanted to highlight. Yeah. But specifically...
Yes, please go ahead.
Specifically, there is no, like usually we will give a call. Even that call, you can make use of it and start sending your applications. If not, the call, you need not have to wait for the calls. You can drop a mail to the contact slide, which I'm going to share now on the screen. So it will be easy for you to reach out to us.
Right. Can you put it in full screen?
Yeah. One minute. Okay.
Right. Yeah. So we have support at
annaincubator.org.
And the website is www.annaincubator.org, right?
.org. Yes, correct.
So this is for everyone's information. So my experience with Anna Incubator has been like CED. So those who are related to Anna University will understand. CED had been, you know, interacting with students. And we try to refine their ideas and, you know, prepare them so that they are open to, you know, going into any incubation center. And in the last pre-incubation program, we are really proud two of our students were shortlisted for the pre-incubation program. And also two of the startups who have been, you know, working on their prototypes with the state government funding scheme, such as the IVP, Innovation Voucher Program, they have been incubated now successfully at Atal Incubation. So the way Uma Ma'am also mentioned in the beginning, CED and Anna Incubator, we have been working together, and I think that we complement each other, right? So I request all students and all the, you know, those who are listening to us, you could come down to CED first to understand how the ecosystem is, and, you know, you can share your idea. You can, at whatever stage you are, you could let us know, and or you could directly go to the Anna Incubator and, you know, get yourselves incubated or at whatever stage you want to. Uma, one question that students have been asking me, some of them are looking only for co-working space, you know, some kind of office space. So what is your, what do you offer?
They can come down here, see the facility. If this is convincing, they can take up the co-working space. We charge them on a monthly basis for the number of seats they would like to occupy.
Right. And what are the other facilities they get along with the seat?
They can get internet connectivity, and beyond that, they get access to the. They can have few mentoring sessions as well. So they want to get technical mentorship, technical discussion.
Part of that.
Yes,
and of course, coffee, all that will obviously.
Yes. Our co-working space will have coffee facility, coffee maker, library will be there. Technical, all softwares will be available. They can make use of it, whatever is required at that point of time. The minimal requirement, minimal requisition note, they can make use of that. These are available.
So I think I am done with
my. We have a dedicated parking space too. So you can park your vehicles as well. So those are the amenities that you can enjoy.
Yeah, that's nice thing to add. Chennai being a metro city, and we are located in the very hotspot of the city. Fine. So any of you has any other question? We can still take up a couple more questions.
Please.
Anybody wants to unmute, interact with Uma Ma'am, please feel free to do that. Meanwhile, others who are thinking to wind off, please fill this feedback link. Please fill the form in the feedback link. And this is the contact detail. The email and the website has been provided in the chat box for Atal Incubation Center, Anna Atal Incubation Center. Others, please, any questions, please unmute yourself and ask. So I think you've really addressed very well, Uma. So I think people are full of information, loaded with that. Now they want to visit the Anna Incubation Center.
Yes, the best thing or the first thing that I want anyone to do is, like, if you want to understand what does an incubator wants to provide on a live way with a lot of details, you can drop into the Anna Incubator, I mean, which is in the campus, Anna University campus, very much right opposite to CED. So you can right away come down here, visit us with all facilities. You can have a view, and then you can decide on in what way, and you can make use of the incubator. So that's one way. We leave it to the discretion of the decision makers, the startup owners, to make, because I may tell 1,000 things, but you may want only one or two stops, which you can pick. You can be choosy enough to ask what you want from an incubator as well. So please make your presence to the incubator, and you can right away. We are available here 24/7. Like, even not 24/7, our startups are available, because we give them a specific access card to sit and work on the co-working space. So co-working space is completely a discretionary space. It's not with us. It's completely managed and maintained by the startups themselves. So that's the way. There will be people available here in an incubator at any point of time. So should not be a problem. You can drop in any day and visit the facilities.
Right. So for the information of students who have just joined the university, CED and Anna Incubation Center, we are located in the Platinum Jubilee Building, which is in the AC Tech campus and next to the AC Tech canteen. So if you see, with respect to the Gandhi Mandapam, we are just opposite to the Gandhi Mandapam in the campus, right? So you could ask anybody, and the other department buildings are that are near to Platinum Jubilee Building are the Crystal Growth Center and the Center for Biotechnology and India and Institute for Remote Sensing. So if you could locate this, you could really reach the Platinum Research Building, and we are on the second floor. CED and Anatal Incubation, both are on the second floor. So I hope we'll see more visits, we'll see more queries from the people who attended today, and see, we have the Students Entrepreneurship Club also attending. I'm very thankful to Deepthi, who has brought the students along. So with that, I would like to thank Dr. Uma Maheshwari for the wonderful session, and you made it so interactive and answered all the queries very well. Thank you so much, Uma, and we look forward to, you know, get associated further in future.
Thank you, Sangeeta. Thanks, CED, for this opportunity. Thank you all participants for being so patient and for being so enthusiastic about understanding the startup ecosystem and the incubator's role. Thank you so much for this wonderful session.
All right. Thank you, Uma. So for the participants, thank you so much for attending this. I hope it was really a fried up session for you, and you're going back or you're logging off with a lot of information on incubation centers. There is a feed-